sponsors the Brewers' course, who will present the trophy at the end. Will he be presenting it to Rio Ferdinand? Here's the late...
Four and a half, really. And it's given the world's best footballer a very early chance to work a goalkeeper who, by his own standard, thought three words would be in my mind. Work the goalkeeper.
Ronaldo!
Power's there, and it's a good distance to get it on target. He just sets it off a little too high. Think what they go, I mean that. Just think, you know, I know Gomez is experienced and he's probably better than he's shown at times. He is a lot better than he's shown, but he'll be a little nervy, worried until he makes his first save.
And Spurs, when they're defending free kicks and corners, will be a little nervy with the way that Gomez has handled that kind of situation before. Here's Ronaldo. Tevez, Suakoto straight to Nani. Looking to play it into Tevez, can he turn? Lines it up for Ronaldo! And directly at Gomez.
What you have to cope with, passing and moving. This is sloppy, you cannot do this against Manchester United. And watch how quickly they go from where they are to a shot on the other side of the pitch. Nani coming infield. A little protection there and just strangled the shot a little. Hit it to the ground. Gibson did well breaking it up. When Modric gets in that area, he's got to make it work for Tottenham.
Here's Ronaldo looking to pick it up against the Suakoto. Tevez. Now John O'Shea. Ronaldo, three in the middle for him. Tripping against the Suakoto. It's further. Here's Ronaldo. It's a foul by Zakor.
Might have gone wide to Pavlyuchenko, Jermaine Genus.
To Ronaldo. Ronaldo cuts it across, looking for Welbeck. King behind it. Scholes. Here's Gibson. Ronaldo finding Tevez. Pretty useful presence as it is. As Modric lifts it in. Away by Evans, Dawson looking to get on it, cleared to Ronaldo. Scores. And Ronaldo did really well there, showed plenty of desire.
High bounce does Ronaldo a favour, just a little unlucky with his ball back to Tevez. Good.
Taking on Chorluka, clipping one over for Ronaldo to rescue. Shuffle again from Ronaldo, back off for Suakoto. O'Shea underneath it, cleared by Dawson. Free. Ronaldo. Moved on to John O'Shea. Which team comes out on top? Which team supporters really are the 12th man? Ronaldo. O'Shea's moved on. It's Tevez. Pavlyuchenko. Now Modric. Away by Ronaldo. Here's Tevez. Genus got to the ball. It's deadlocked. Manchester United 0, Tottenham.
You've attempted to introduce someone like Bentley.
I don't think you'll change it at the moment, no. I think Spurs have grown in
encouragement with the way that Spurs finished the half compared with how they'd started the half. So Ronaldo's little flick.
Often teams get caught cold, having sitting there in dressing room, manager telling them you've done quite well, come out. Little sloppy, little slack. Made to pay for it. No Berbatov, even on the bench. Of course, Harry doesn't have one through injury and one through cup tie. So he's a bit short at the top end. The 35-year-old legs that are sitting on the bench at the moment. Well, they put people in there, United, but I can't think of this going anywhere else but towards Aurelio Gomez's goal. Unless he kids everyone and just stands this up, but I would be very, very surprised if that happens.
Here he goes again, Ronaldo! No joy.
Yeah. Again, the power's there. And going across him, I'm a little surprised he missed it that side, near side.
Danny Welbeck. O'Shea. Ronaldo. O'Shea. And Ronaldo's in here!
Well, why is he not taking this on? He'll work it beautifully. It's the first real threat he's had away from Modric. And just smash it. They get in the line, the three United players, all of them. But I thought Cristiano Ronaldo, with his shooting power, even from a tight angle, would have been putting his laces through the back of that ball and really working the goalkeeper. So Genus, Lennon, have all worked incredibly hard in this game. Interesting to see just how long, if they have an effect on the game.
Beyond him to John O'Shea. Here's Ronaldo. Does make sure Luka with his footwork again. And Evra. Here's Anderson. Ronaldo. Cleared by King. Picks up another beautiful ball to Ronaldo. Trying to get inside to Suakoto. And it's broken again for Ronaldo. Back by Tevez. Of the manager's ire in that disastrous second leg of the semi-final against Burnley. And after the free kick earlier in that last effort, I'm sure he will be again if Spurs don't go on to win this. Ronaldo. King and Suakoto in each other's way, but King...
Well, I do think if Pavlyuchenko's performance doesn't improve in 5 minutes, I think then Harry Redknapp was seriously thinking of bringing on another midfield player and just sort of matching it up like for like and tucking Modric infield and just say, play along.
O'Shea!
That's a silly foul. I think it is a foul. He's in the perfect angle to see this, the referee, and I think Modric just leans into Ronaldo. Keep an eye on it coming in. There you go. It just eases him out. When you think of that one he smashed in against Paul Robinson recently. Therefore, Modric has to occupy Paul's goals.
Here's Tevez. Ronaldo. Now Scholes. Take on Suakoto. King stuck out a leg and the referee has shown a yellow card to Ronaldo for diving.
Well, in a lot of times I have some sympathy with this player. You watch his right foot of Ledley King. Comes out there and catches him. And I mean catches him wrong. I think that's a penalty. Let me tell you now. He wins the ball, he's tackled. I think that's a penalty. That was my first reaction. Penalty.
Well, he can't believe it, Cristiano Ronaldo.
I swear, you watch Ledley King's right leg come out. He wins the ball, catches Ronaldo's right foot. It's a penalty.
Well, he could have had a clearer view of it, the referee.
Chelsea United penalty, Gary.
Well, you know, with the advantage of seeing the replays, you know, it definitely catches him. But I've got to say, Jeff, it's just his reputation going before him. There's no doubt about that in my mind. But the thing for me that gave it away, his reaction here. Normally when he goes...
Cleared by Ferdinand.
They've worked it round the midfield really well.
Wembley, still Manchester United and Tottenham cancel each other out. Here's Evans. Ronaldo. Gibson. Looking forward as well.
To
Anderson trying to pick out Cristiano Ronaldo. Tevez has got into the box now. There's Nani.
Well, this must be right on his maximum.
To go. Ronaldo strikes this one against the wall.
Jamie O'Hara's been smacked.
Well, I have to say, Rob, I've got no idea why he's stopping the game.
I did hit him in the face. Gibson. Ronaldo. Evans.
I guess his only question would be, is Paul Scholes okay? You know, he'll ask Scholes, I'm sure, can you go another 30? If he gets yes, I can. It might be young Darren Gibson.
Ronaldo pulling it across for Tevez. Scholes. Gibson. Ronaldo. Into the last 30 seconds we go. Ronaldo inside to Sirikoto. Hits the post. Nani's there. And he can't follow it up. And what a chance for United to snatch it at the death.
Wouldn't that just been the headline writer's dream? The world's greatest footballer, right on cue, with 30 seconds left, smashes the winner. And how unlucky is he? Nani might have done better, but it's all about this. The first time he's really driven by Sirikoto in this match, and Sir Alex thinks his team have won it, but they haven't, not just yet anyway.
Will be an extra 30. Ronaldo denied a penalty, but denied at the end.
And then hitting the post in the last seconds, you think, is it Spurs' day? It could be Spurs' day.
I think Ronaldo wanting a bit of clarification there about that penalty decision. Clearly caught, but his reputation perhaps has gone before him. Who do you favour now, Gary?
You know, the introduction of
width of the post denying Ronaldo as well.
Well, I guess there's two schools of thought, whatever camp you're in. You'd say if you're a United fan now, there you go. You've mentioned it, St David's Day.
King's header. Evans away to Ronaldo. Now Giggs.
What you might find, Rob, more than 1v1s. Players get tired and not quite get back and support the way they've been.
Keeping it alive here for Nani. Changes in the air for Tottenham. Harry Redknapp having used only one of his substitutes so far in bringing O'Hara on for Pavlyuchenko. Ronaldo looking for Tevez. Gomez had to Anderson. Tevez. Ronaldo pulls it across. And Genus gets there. Anderson. Ronaldo. Evans. And towards Giggs. He helps it back to Ronaldo. Giggs again. It's Nani. Digs it out for Scholes. Ronaldo. And he's won a corner. Lennon may be starting to feel the effects of the long slog now. Here's Ronaldo. Out to Evans.
Cross it. Bentley, O'Hara and Bale are now in there. So they have the legs in there now.
Here's Ronaldo.
He's always less accurate a little with that left foot than his right. Certainly capable, but just turned straight round without taking on some liquid, without the map.
Harry Redknapp has spoken his words. Cristiano Ronaldo may still be turning over in his mind that big opportunity right at the end of 90 minutes. Modric, met by Evans.
Lazy little ball up from Bentley. It was a tired response from Luka Modric.
He's back on now, Michael Dawson. He's back on in his customary position, but...
they've always got five at the back now. Spurs have tucked Chaluka in one. They've got Bale at right back.
Here's Johnny Evans. Cristiano Ronaldo. Away by Assar. So we're 3 minutes away from the first goalless League Cup final in 25 years and only the second penalty shootout in the final.
Paul scores.
Ronaldo.
I think much like they did in Moscow, I think, didn't they? Rogo first.
That's right, the only one that was missed in that particular shootout was by...
They're all important. He trotted up. Did he trot up third? This
he
position?
Did.
You
did.
Think he did. And he trotted up and missed it.
Only the third one lucky here for Manchester United. Ronaldo going at number three in the order again. He missed in Moscow. But he scores at Wembley.
Almost as if he waited for Gomez because he just rolls it very centrally. It's not in the corner like the other two. Watch. Stemmer. There you go.
In the end, fatigue beat Tottenham. After a goalless draw, beaten Spurs here on penalties, 4-1.
In many respects, Gary, you know, Ben Foster, it's quite appropriate that he's had such an impact in the penalty shootout because he has had a big day.
Yeah, it was a good save, but you've got to say it's a nice height. Jamie O'Hara's penalty, I don't know if you felt in the shooter here that his run-up wasn't that confident. It was a good save, a nice height for the keeper, and the camera seen by Bentley is missing the target completely.